Hello. So I am recording these a little bit out of order. Please excuse me if I get myself a little confused that way, but let's see if we can get through it. We're talking about arithmetic sequences today. An arithmetic sequence is really one which, bottom line, is kind of going to look like a line if I were going to graph all these points. There is a common difference between every term, meaning to go from one step to the next step, you just add or subtract, or I guess add a negative if you're into that kind of thing, the same amount every single time. So if it were to look like this with a first term, which we could call a sub one, my next term would look like a sub one plus d. Now I could call that a sub two, and my next term would be a sub two plus d. Well, since a sub 2 is a sub 1 plus d, this one must be a sub 1 plus 2d, and so on and so forth. So, looking over here, this sequence, 3, 7, 11, 15, 19, I just did some subtraction here, found that common difference, and it is common. It is all that same difference. So my difference is 4, and my first term is 3. Once again, looks a little bit like those linear equations, and we're going to see that in just another example or two, I suppose. Is this sequence arithmetic? And I'm going to vote no on that. From 2 to 4, we go up by 2. From 4 to 6, we go up by 2. From 6 to 10, we go up by 4. So right there is enough to tell us that it is not. So we cannot really get a D, a common difference. We can, of course, get that first term, but not what we're looking for. Okay, so now this generic one defined by a sub n equals 1 minus 4n. And again, that looks kind of a little bit like mx plus b. Let's see that it is arithmetic. If I were to plug in 1 for n, I'd get 1 minus 4 times n, I'd get negative 3. If I were to plug in 2, I would basically be subtracting another 4, I'd get negative 7, subtract a negative 4, subtract a negative 4. That difference, of course, is the negative 4, and my starting term is that negative 3. The slope really is that common difference. The y-intercept, though, really isn't a y-intercept because we don't start with a zeroth term. We start with the first, so a little bit different. Here's one which is surprisingly arithmetic, but if we remember, a exponent in a log can become a coefficient. So for the first one, there's an implied coefficient of 1, then an implied coefficient of 2, and an implied coefficient of 3. In this particular one, both my common difference and my starting point are the same thing. I'm just going up by the natural log of 4 each time. Okay, so in this particular case, they gave me the first and the first and the third of those things. So I had to figure out what that common difference was. Well, I said to go from the first one to the second one, I must have added an x. To go from the second one to the third one, I might have added an x. So to go straight from the first to the third, I must have added that 2x. So that difference is 11. 2x must equal 11, and x equals 5.5. Notice that that's not one of my terms. That's my common difference. So I either added it to my first one or subtracted it from my third one to find my middle one. From my third one, if I add another 5.5 and add another 5.5, I end up with my fourth and fifth terms. Now, we can do that with some formulas, and those come up right here. So this is an explicit formula for finding the nth term. The recursive formula is just where you take the previous term and you add that common difference. Here we're saying, okay, well, if I'm specifically looking for, let's say, the 100th term, I certainly don't want to have to first find the 99th term. And to do that, I don't want to have to find the 98th term and the 97th, 6th, 5th, 4th, all of the above. So instead, what we're going to do is we're going to say, okay, well, to get to the 100th term, for example, you are going to start at your first term and you're going to add that common difference, not 100 times, because you didn't have to add it at all to get to the first term, but that 100 minus 1, or in general, that n minus 1. So find the explicit formula for the nth term of an arithmetic sequence, and then find the fifth term if the first term is 5, okay, first term is 5, and the common difference is 8. So to go from the first term to the eighth term, to the fifth term, excuse me, I'm going to add 8 a bunch of times. How many times? Well, 5 minus 1 times, 4 times. So I'm going to start at 5, and I'm going to add 4 of those 8s, 5 plus 32, and I'm going to get a 37 right there. By the way, this is a formula which I would expect you to be able to understand to the point where memorizing it would be somewhat moot. We applied that formula, find the 31st term of the sequence, which goes from 2 to 8 to 14 to 20. Well, it has a common difference of 6. If I'm going to the 31st term, I am adding 30 of those 6s to the first term. So I'm adding 30 times 6. I'm adding 180 to 2. I get 182. I have a small child behind me. Hello, small child. Ah, that is the end of education as we know it. Right. You know what? Perhaps the rest of this can be somewhat self-explanatory. I've got an answer of negative 32 and a couple of answers down here at the bottom. I'll let you freeze on that. A couple answers down here at the bottom. Because they did ask for a recursive formula in addition to finding out what d and a sub 1 are. Recall that a recursive formula involves knowing what the first term is. I have another issue which I'm going to take care of right now. Thank you. Bye.